This is Pat with Pat's Two Cents, and I am so honored and excited to have Lannette Duncan with us. We are going to talk today. This is a warning for everyone. Please listen. The name of this talk, this is the beginning of sorrows. Lannette, I am so glad that you're joining us, and I pray that God uses you in a mighty way and that people listen. I'm going to read Matthew 24, and then I'm going to read Revelations, and you take over from there. God bless you, Lannette. All right. Matthew 24, starting at verse 3. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, "Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?" And Jesus answered and said unto them, "Take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. All these are the beginning of sorrows." Revelations chapter 6, verse 1 through 8. "And I saw the Lamb open one of the seals, and I heard as it were the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, Come and see. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown that was given unto him. And he went forth conquering and to conquer. And when he had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, Come and see. And there went out another horse that was red, and power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth, and that they should kill one another. And there was given unto him a great sword. And when he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, Come and see. And I beheld, and lo, a black horse. And he that sat on him had a pair of balances in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, A measure of wheat for a penny, and three measures of barley for a penny. And see thou hurt not the oil and the wine. And when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast say, Come and see. And I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death. And hell followed with him, and power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth to kill with sword, and with hunger, and with death, and with the beast of the earth." Amen. God bless you, Lannette.
The Lord gave me this message, and it was heavy. And it is not an easy message to give, but I give it with urgency. And I want everybody who has ears to hear. If you have the Spirit of God, ask God to reveal to you if this is the truth or not, if this is Him or not saying that. Because I know in these last days, we must have discernment, and we must test the Spirit by the Spirit. So I would like to go ahead and share with you what the Lord gave me.
Amen.
Last year, we all know that the 2020 was a very bad year with the COVID-19 pandemic. Well, as we all know, they've given, I would say that in the last past couple of months, you know, they have let everybody know, well, we've got the vaccine out there, COVID-19, we've turned a corner, everything's going to be okay. They started opening up, you know, all of your amusement parks, restaurants, no masks, pretty much, you know, giving the impression of, I want to say, a false sense of security.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing, the Lord always kept His hand on me. I just never believed it. This whole year, since January, I just didn't believe it. And it was as if the Lord was telling me, just wait and just watch. Remember what I told you, daughter? And I said, okay, I'm going to sit back, like the Lord said, and just wait and watch and observe. Well, in India, I want to say about a month ago, maybe two, they had a strange case of COVID-19, they thought, an outbreak that was terrible. It wiped out so many people so fast. Mm. And then they discovered that it wasn't the COVID-19 that we had often, you know, we had learned about and got the vaccine for, but it was a mutant. It was called the Delta variant of COVID-19. And I started to pray, and the Lord said, this is what you need to do. You need to start praying now, because that Delta variant will be in the United States sooner than you know. And sure enough, within about a month later, that Delta variant is here. It's in California, it's in the Midwest, it's in Nevada. Australia has already gone on lockdown as I speak. There's 80 countries that this Delta virus, Delta variant, has traveled to. And it is aggressive. It's extremely aggressive. It spreads three times as fast. It's very contagious. And it's more severe than COVID-19. And some of the symptoms, I was told, I went and did some research and listened to some doctors, is they say it emulates a bad cold. There's a sore throat, really bad headache, runny nose, fever. Sounds, you know, simple, right? But it's deadly and it's dangerous. They are also saying that it seems to be affecting younger people in their 20s. Mm-hmm. Also, they have discovered that even if you have had the vaccine, that there are people that have still been able to get sick from this. So now, as I speak, California is on a mandated, we must wear a mask again, whether you're vaccinated or not. It's just proven that what the Word of God, as Sister Pat was reading, Matthew, I'll refer back to that, when the Lord said this is the beginning of sorrow, that there would be pestilence and famine. They are also coming along with the Delta variant. Food shortages, famine, if you may. There is also currently right now a drought in California. So the water, they're talking about the water shortage. And basically what the Lord shared with me is there were over, I want to say, 4 million worldwide COVID-related deaths in 2020, the Lord told me it's going to be triple death rate. So you do the math. And that's why Revelation 6 comes in, because this pale horse, pay attention to that, what his job is, mm-hmm. is death, to kill with death and pestilence and famine. And it's here. I just ask that everybody would just open their eyes. I get it. We're all tired of being locked down in the house. We all want things to go back to normal. I get it. I understand that. But what you must understand is things will never be the same. And I know that's a hard thing to accept. I know that we can't even imagine not being able to go back to how things were or having some type of normalcy. It will never be. And we have to accept this. If you're a believer, Jesus told us that this world is passing away, but my word will never pass away. But he already told us, those of us that believe in Jesus, that this world is passing away as you know it. Nothing will ever be the same again. And we need to, those of us who are believers, we need to take this warning seriously, because this Delta variant is so aggressive and it's no joke. And I'm telling you, you can go on Google, you can go on YouTube, you can go anywhere on any of the on the internet, and you will see, just to prove, just so you can say, well, this lady is not some, you know, kook talking, just putting stuff out here trying to scare folks. You're going to see, well, whoa, wait a minute, what? I didn't know this was going on. Some of you do know, but a lot of people do not know that this thing is out here, is out there on the move, and then seeking whom it may devour, just like the devil. But Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And this Delta variant is like the devil himself. It's getting anybody it can. And it's, I understand, too, that it's taking people out of here in as quick as 48 hours, some people. And it's dangerous. It's just not a good thing.
Nope.
And then to add on to that, there's they said that it's called the Delta variant. Now there's a Delta Plus. So on top of that, we had COVID-19, we got the Delta. Now we got the Delta Plus. So I don't know what's going on or why these viruses are mutating like they're doing so fast and so quick. But I will share with you guys. We need to be vigilant. We need to double up anything we were doing last year to keep ourselves healthy, whether it was our diet, taking vitamins, doing the social distancing, wearing the mask, do all of that, and some, whatever else you can, the Lord will share with you to do, or anything else you can know to do. This stuff is out here to steal, kill, and destroy, and it's here, and all you got to do is Google it, or get on YouTube, and you will see. Look up Delta Plus or Delta Variant. It came from India. This time it came from India, and there's something else that comes with it. I don't really know too much about it. I don't like to really talk about too much stuff I don't know about. But there's something called the Black Death, or something that affects the bones. This stuff is nasty, you guys. It's nasty. It's horrible. And there's going to be triple the death amount. I gave you the numbers. Last year, 2020, 4 million worldwide COVID-related deaths. It's going to be three times that much in 2021. And I lost some people I love. And, you know, I'm just really concerned for everybody that has let their guards down. Some of you have been out and about. Because, you know, they gave you a false sense of security. It's not your fault. You know, but you've been out and about and you've been around people and just going back to normal, mm-hmm. and had no idea. Some of you didn't have no idea that this was out there. Take care of yourselves, please. God loves you and he doesn't want any of us to suffer. So that was what was on my heart, was to make you aware. This is a heads up, a wake up call. I'm ringing the bell, whatever you want to call it. It's real, and it's going to be really bad, and this is the beginning of sorrow. So I'll end with that, but know that God is in control. Mm-hmm. He takes care of his own, and with that, be encouraged and know that God is in control, but he wants us to be vigilant and do our due diligence, mm-hmm. and doing our part, and mm-hmm. he will do the rest. He's faithful. Yes, he will. Thank you so much, Sister Pat, for allowing mm-hmm. me to share this with the people.
Thank you so much. I just hope everybody listens. That's what I hope.
Amen.
Yeah, I hope everybody listens, because I already could see we were having a food shortage. You can go to some of these drive-thrus, you know, you want to get a drink or a little shake or whatever, and you ask if they have this, that, or the other, and, oh, well, we don't have that right now.
Right.
They're not able to deliver it, so we haven't been able. Or you ask if they have mushrooms, or you ask if they have grilled chicken or whatever. And it's shocking, the things, the basic things, honey yes. mustard, basic things they don't have. So it's already beginning. Yes. That part has already yes. begun. So
yeah,
I really hope
true.
And
that's
pray
true.
That everybody listens, pays attention, and prays for God's guidance and direction. He will direct you. He will protect you if you get up under his protection. But if you're not asking and you're not listening, I don't know what to say to you. Anything else you want to add, Lannette? Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Just that, you know, the urgency, you know, if anything, the urgency. And I just urge you to check it out for yourself, because I know a lot of us, I'm like that too. You know, somebody's telling me something, and it's something I don't want to hear, and I'm like, I don't know about that. I'm urging you, check it out.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out.
Mm-hmm.
Delta variant. It
yes.
is here, and it is killing people. It has already killed so many people already, just mm-hmm. in the last month. And I'm in California, so Governor Newsom put this out. This is Sunday, the 18th. Just last night, it went into effect that California is mandated to wear masks, vaccinated or not. We're going right back to where we started from. See, it's going right back. People, look at it. Just check it out. Just look at it. Pay attention. Look at what's going on. I thought everything was okay. See, that's where I'm coming from. I'm like, oh, wow, wait a minute. We're going right back to where we started. And don't forget, I said Australia is already on lockdown. Sydney and Melbourne, Australia, they're on lockdown. Stores are being closed right back to the way it was last year. Don't get caught. Don't get caught. Don't, like we used to say back in the day, don't stay ready to keep from getting ready.
Whoa!
Stay ready to keep from getting ready, baby. Mm-hmm. Stay ready to keep from getting ready because it's here. It ain't coming. It's here. And I just want everybody. I love everybody. I don't care if I don't know you or not. I love you. I do not want to see anybody suffer if they didn't have to.
Mm-mm.
And that's about it. All. Like you said, so what else can I say?
Right.
I can't make them. You know, you can take a horse to the water, but you can't make them drink.
Exactly.
I have faith in God, and I have faith in his people, and I have faith even in people that don't even know the Lord. I have faith that y'all are going to listen because, you know, even if you're not, you know, a Christian or don't believe in stuff like this, you can look around just being just a regular person, don't have no kind of faith in nothing. You can see, you feel something's wrong.
Right.
Just a regular person knows that. So I'm talking to everybody,
mm-hmm.
and I love all of you, and I just don't want people to suffer because what I'm hearing is this stuff is so aggressive and it's severe, they say, and it's highly contagious, and the suffering. A friend of mine told me that they put people on ventilators quicker than they did with the COVID-19.
Wow.
Because it affects their respiratory
mm-hmm.
so bad. Mm-hmm.
Wow. And that video you showed me, the one that I looked at where the woman said that when she got it, it felt like her face was filled with concrete. Her face felt like
yes.
concrete. Now, the thing that came to my mind while Lannette was talking and sharing about how when we got all relaxed, thinking everything was over and we were safe, I thought of that scripture that says, when they say peace and safety, then sudden mm-hmm. destruction coming. So you got to be careful, and you can't take things for granted. You can't believe everything they say. You can't believe everything in the media. Remember, Satan is the prince of the air. So you have to consult with the one who really knows. God bless you. Be safe. Be healed. In the name of Jesus. Thank you
Amen.
So much, Lannette. Amen.
You're welcome. Love you, sis.
Love you, too. What are you going to do?